afternoon, YouTube. Welcome to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily, and today we're going to be talking about Star Trek Picard and the teaser trailer. I've had a few days to process it. I had some knee-jerk reactions that I posted to Twitter. It was mostly just confirming all of my worst fears about what the show is going to be about. But I think, honestly, and it's not something I realized until maybe I watched Dan Gunther's video at Kurtrat's Productions about it, where I was just like, it's probably a Romulan voiceover. This is probably a Romulan character. No issue with that. Star Trek Nemesis is a steaming pile of fucking shit and a huge fuck you to the entire canon of Next Generation. But the one thing it did give us was the fact that it opened the door to the Federation and the Romulan Star Empire potentially having an alliance of some kind. Maybe not the Romulan Star Empire joining the Federation, but maybe some better terms of all of shit going down, because Romulans have always been sneaky, stupid fucking assholes. I'm fine with that, obviously. I mean, it doesn't really matter what I think in the grand scheme of things, but you know, me as a person, as a fan, like, okay, I'm fine with including the Romulans and shit like that. Any kind of inclusion of the Kelvin timeline, to me, is bullshit. Quite frankly, I have no interest in revisiting any of that dumb fucking shit. And this is me saying all of that with the fact that I like those movies. They are still open for criticism, okay? They will always be open for criticism. Next Gen, Voyager, DS9, Enterprise, Discovery, they are all art in some form of another. They are all there to be criticized. Nothing that happens in the Kelvin timeline, to me, is all that interesting, is all that compelling, and it's just a big excuse to have explosions. That's how I feel. Can I still watch them and enjoy it? Abso-fucking-lutely. But at the end of the day, it's bullshit Star Trek. It's not real Star Trek to me. And people have been saying that about Discovery, so I don't see why I can't say it about the fucking J.J. Abrams Kelvin fuckery that just happened. You can do something with Romulus and not have it be a fucking supernova. It doesn't have to go supernova. It doesn't at all, because everything that happens in the Kelvin timeline is only because Paramount owns different parts of Star Trek than fucking CBS. Why do we have to mix the two? Is there some kind of merger that's going on? Fine, I'll understand if it's from a business point of view, if it's from some fucking corporate office or some shit like that. If that's where the call is coming from, bro. But if it's only to form a connection to one dumb fucking timeline that is stupid, I need a nail file. I need to do something with my hands. But if you're only doing it because of one fucking timeline that it is completely irrelevant to the Prime Universe, it's totally irrelevant. Part of the thing that I missed when I first watched the trailer that I realized after the fact, because I'm just like, why the fuck would my main man, my captain in the seat, and my gentleman in the streets be disillusioned by Starfleet? Or by the Federation. They also call him an admiral. There's that in there. I was like, why would this guy who's devoted his whole life to service, his whole life to being an ambassador not a literal ambassador, I mean ambassador in a different sense, such an important figure in Starfleet and the Federation, where he's respected by so many people, not including Benjamin Sisko, and beloved by so many people. Why would he be disillusioned by Starfleet and the Federation? You gave your whole life to it, man. Like, that was your thing. Like, you could have gone down the archaeology route, and you chose not to. He chose not to. And then I started thinking about it a little differently. You can devote your whole life to one institution, be it public service, you know, be it to a business, or that you've climbed, like, the ladder of, you know, whatever. You know, I have similar feelings in the job that I have, where I'm owned by a corporation, but I work for a franchise. And I've started at the bottom, and I've over the course of 9 years, I have decided to finally go up into management. And I've watched the company change from within. And it's disheartening, because you're asking people who get tired to perform in ways that are physically impossible sometimes. But we're not gonna go into that. But my point is, I understand how it feels to be disillusioned by something you've given a lot to. You've given a lot of time, you've given a lot of effort to. Sometimes you get injured and you still go back because of the promise that you'll be taken care of. And that you matter. And that you are a invaluable asset to this team, to this family, to this company. So thinking about it in terms of that, something must have really happened to make him be jaded or disillusioned. And a lot of that is projection. A lot of it is also how it's filmed, how I'm the teaser in this case, how it's presented, the context. He's in France, which I'm not fucking happy about. I'm just like, so it just, but then when I, so all good things doesn't matter is what you're telling me. All good things just doesn't matter because he just ends up in the same fucking place. It's like how I feel. Insert spoiler for the series finale of Game of Thrones. It's kind of how I feel about everything that went on with, I feel like this connection in that Jaime Lannister killed the Mad King to save King's Landing, right? That's his whole story arc. That's his whole cross to bear, being the Kingslayer. Daenerys's whole cross to bear is that she comes from a family of batshit fucking crazy people, and she's supposed to break the wheel. I know that there's that, it's in a different context, but you're supposed to break the cycle. She's supposed to be the one who breaks that cycle. I think those two characters are far more connected than most people realize, because it doesn't matter that Jaime killed the Mad King, and it doesn't matter that he saved King's Landing, and it doesn't matter all the way to Z what he's done to better himself, because a mad Targaryen still comes along and destroys King's Landing. I think Daenerys and Jaime are far more connected in that way than any other characters in the show, is that it just doesn't matter, bro. So that's kind of how I feel with this Picard thing and all good things. I'm just kind of like, it doesn't fucking matter. Okay, fine, I'll just go fuck myself in the eye and just shut the fuck up, because you have to make these things matter. You have to give them meaning. And again, I know I'm jumping the gun and I'm prejudging it, and I'm sorry. I am. I'm not trying to rain on anybody's parade. I'm excited about it, but not as much as I was. And you know what? The thing is, the first time I saw a trailer for Star Trek Discovery, I was just like, what did I just watch? I thought the song was shit. I thought the editing was weird. And I just was looking at it like... But I also had the issue of reading a lot of speculation, reading a lot of pre-reviews of people hating it, and when I finally watched it from episode to episode, I was like, okay, my fears were unfounded. Okay, it's actually not that bad. It's really not that bad, guys. There's far worse things out there. So I'm saying this with the hope of being wrong. I've said it before, and I will say it again. I have no issue being wrong. The older you get, the less of a fuck you give about things that don't actually matter that much. Star Trek Picard is not going to make me love or hate Star Trek. It's not going to be this tipping point of whether or not I lose all hope or all faith in an entire franchise. If that was going to happen, it would have been a lot earlier than that. And I know it's just a teaser. I know we haven't seen anything else. And I'm really looking forward to seeing a trailer with more information that is given. Besides, you know, vagueness. But that's what a teaser is for. It's supposed to be vague. It's a teaser, for fuck's sake. And I'm glad it actually did what a teaser is supposed to do. And it only was like a minute or 10 seconds long or something like that. Maybe a little bit longer. Instead of a teaser being dropped about a fucking Avengers movie. And it's like 2.5-3 minutes long. And I'm like, that's not a teaser. That's a full-length theatrical fucking trailer. How much more footage do you got that you're gonna show me in the next two trailers? Is it two different scenes? Maybe a different angle? A different shot of Chris Hemsworth's beard? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how to feel about it. Again, I've said it before, but this is a day for Lily quotes. I literally doubt everything. I doubt everything. I doubt the sincerity of people and the genuineness of things that I care about, controlled by people who might only be in it for money. It's made me a tough person to please. I get it. That's something I need to work on. If this is his third act, if what we see in the teaser is just the eradication of his entire journey up until all good things, I'm just gonna be pretty... Again, I 100% support the fact that I might be wrong. Support the fact that I might be wrong? That doesn't make any sense. I want to be wrong. And I get that drama is heavily involved in everything that we watch nowadays. There has to be drama and shit. And I get it. I totally get it. And I love drama. I love a good drama every now and then. But what happened to the hope? You know, yeah, you can give your whole life to one service and one job and one company and one business or whatever, and you can get fucked over by it. And that's realistic. And I don't want to be lied to. But it's also a shitty message to send, too. So just don't work hard, then. Don't try to be good at a job or a hobby. Or don't try. That's also how it feels, is don't try to be good at anything. Because you're just going to get fucked over by the thing you're good at. It's just like, okay, that's a positive message to send. We're all just speculating. We're all just speculative little bees buzzing around. And this is just me. This is just me. This is like the third video I've made about Star Trek Picard. Like one I made like 7 months ago, 8 months ago at this point, where I was talking literally about this thing happening. And I don't want it to be connected to the fucking Kelvin timeline. I'm just like, fuck the Kelvin timeline. Can we just move on? Why does Romulus have to get destroyed? Like, if that's where they're going with it, why? Why do you need to fucking destroy an entire planet? That's not hope. That doesn't give me any hope. I'm just like, ooh. They're only going to join the Federation because they're being eradicated by some terrible fucking cataclysmic event. It's not going to be because their best and brightest met with the Federation's best and brightest, and they formed a united bond because of Picard? No, it has to be because they have no choice. Their hands are fucking tied, guys. They're fucking tied, and they have no choice but to join the Federation. Because we got a supernova aimed at your fucking head.
Now you have to join the party that everyone's involved in.
It's like, that's a shitty message to send. Again, just speculating. I'm a jaded bitch. Just like my boy's gonna be, apparently, in Star Trek Picard. He looks like a jaded fucking bitch. So, you know, whatever. I did like the flute at the end. I was like, ah! I loved when Picard played his flute. But yeah, that's just how I feel. Sorry, this wasn't a more, like, gung-ho thing where everyone's jumping on the, yeah, it's gonna be great bandwagon. I'm like, yeah, well, it could also be a steaming fucking turd. Let's just be realistic about this guy. His chances are it won't be bad. There's a very good chance it won't be bad, and it will please me, and it will surprise me, and I am hoping so much for that. But the jaded bitch won't believe it until she sees it. I'm sorry. I'm one of those people. I have to see it. I have to see it. Just like years ago when it was at work and everyone was going on about that fucking mermaid documentary. And I'm like, it's literally all fake. It's literally all fake. They say it. Why the fuck are you believing it? Why are you believing it? And someone's like, Lily, why wouldn't you believe in the existence of mermaids? I'm like, because I've never fucking seen one. I don't believe in things that I can't see, that I can't touch, that aren't tangible, that have no substance or texture or aren't tactile. I don't fucking believe in that shit. It's like, yeah, I'll just go outside and look for fucking Sasquatch too while I'm at it, okay? I was like, yeah, I'll just go and look for a fucking gnome and some fairies. And then they were just like, well, you can't believe in Megalodon and not believe in mermaids. We have fucking teeth. I could go to a museum and be like, hey, show me a fucking tooth of a Megalodon. And they'd be like, here you go. Boom. Bitch fucking existed. Do we have a fucking skeletal remain of a fucking mermaid? No. They were seeing fucking manatees. Don't try and fucking tell me different. Do I believe in giant squid? Abso-fucking-lutely, because we have seen them. You fucking shit at me? Don't you dare compare my beautiful motherfucking majestic giant squid, which I love, by the way. I have a fear of water and deep and all that other shit, but I love squid. I fucking love giant squid. That shit, fuck yeah, I'm totally on board. Because we fucking seen it, bitch. So don't try and compare my motherfucking squid to your goddamn stupid as fuck mermaid. Mic drop. I love that I derail my own videos. I don't even need, like, a fucking co-host. I got me. I don't know why I just picked that up. Sorry, Ellie. I just woke Ellie up from her nap. Hey, Goo! Wait, come here. Come here. Come to me. Come to me, pet. Come here. Come here. Come here. Loyal my ass. Okay, I'm done being a freak and harassing my dog. I was like, oh yeah, this video's gonna be super short. I just tell him how much I'm not looking forward to it. And then it's 20 minutes long. You know how many times I say, so yeah, in a video and I cut it out? I think that's all I've got. I guess I'll plug my social media in here somewhere, even though I've never done that before and I don't really care. You don't have to follow me. I seriously doubt most of my audience has Twitter or Instagram. But I do have a Vimeo account. If you don't know what Vimeo is, just go and fucking Google it. I don't really need to explain it to you. Most people know what it is. But basically, I've been making Star Trek related music videos. It is a hobby. It is a fun little editing. It's a fun little way of staying fresh with different kinds of editing that I really enjoy. You can go and check it out in a link below. I think it's called like Pharaoh Hazard Edits. I've only posted 2 videos, but I really like them. I really like them. So maybe you will. I don't know. But yeah. How do you feel about this Star Trek Picard? I know a few of you are probably really excited about it, and I'm sorry to be a Debbie Downer, but like I said, I doubt everything. I doubt everything until I can see it. That's what I got. That's all I got today. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper, and stay tuned and turned on for more.
Getting the W-E-T space F-double-O-D. You are really not impressed by anything that I'm doing right now, are you? She's like, oh my god, just leave me in peace, you crazy bitch. Who's got a little Buddha belly?
Actually, you don't. You've lost your weight, which is good. We don't want those little knees to snap.
Or your little heart to give out. Oh!